1927, I had me a farm, and I call that heaven. Price is up and the rains come down, I haul my crops all into town. I got the money, bought some groceries and some clothes, I fed the kids and raised a big old family. Then the rains quit and the winds got high, and a dirty old dust storm filled the sky. Traded my farm for a Ford machine and poured it full of this gasoline. Started rocking and rolling, deserts and mountains, right on out to the old Peach Bowl. Well, way up yonder on the mountain road, I had a hot engine and a heavy load. Going pretty fast, stopping, was bouncing up and down like popcorn a popping. Had a breakdown, kind of a nervous bust out of sorts. A mechanic feller up there told me I had engine trouble.
That's what you got, boy, engine trouble.
Well, way up yonder on a mountain road, way up yonder in the piney wood, give that rolling Ford a shove. And a rolling, picking up speed, got my hairpin turn. Well, I didn't quite make it. Man alive, I'm telling you, them fiddles and guitars really flew. Oh yes, that Ford took off like a flying squirrel. She flew halfway around the world, scattered my kids, wife, and me all over the side of that mountain. Well, we got to California, so dadgum broke, so dadgum hungry, I thought I'd croak. But I bummed a potato or two, and the wife fixed up some tater stew. Poured the kids full of it and bedded down. Lord, man, I'm telling you, that surely was thin tater stew. So damn thin, I mean, I could read a magazine through it. Look at the pretty pictures, too. Pretty whiskey bottles.
Women.
Naked women and such. Well, I've always thought, I've always figured, I've always contended that if that stew had been just a little bit, politicians could have seen through it.
Well, I heard that on station KVFW, Tijuana, in Los Angeles. Went right down to meet that fella. It's the first time I heard Woody sing a song. It was 1936. And we got together. We went off into the Imperial Valley and for the lettuce picker strike. We sang for the migratory workers, most of the Okies from his home state. We went on up north to the so-called John Steinbeck country in Salinas, up around through Indio in the date country, and we there where they were picking the apples and the peaches and the cherries, we helped pick apricots. Woody made up a song there that's pretty popular too. Pastures of plenty.
It's a mighty full of feet has traveled a hot, dusty road. Out of your dust bowls and westward we roll, and your deserts was hot and your mountain was cold.
California weather around here tonight, too.
I've worked in your orchards of peaches and prunes. I've slept on the ground in the light of your moon. On the edge of your city, you'll see us, and then we come with the dust and we go I've made all your crops, then it's north up to Oregon to gather your hops. Dig the beets from the ground, cut the grapes from the vine, to sit upon your table, them light sparkling wines. Green pastures of plenty from dry desert ground, from the Grand Coulee Dam, where the waters run down. Ever stayed in this union as migrants has been, we'll work in this fight and we'll fight too. It's always we ramble that river and I, all along your green valley I'll work till I die. My lands I'll defend with my life if it be, for my pastures of plenty must always be.
Woody and I got a job in Hollywood in a picture called Fight for Life, Peril Rents, U.S. Film Service. We both got our job because our wives were pregnant. Fragrant, as Woody called it then. The picture need eight-month wives long gone to be taken in the picture at a certain time. Well, when we were up in this part of the country, we'd done the first shooting. I was a doctor in the picture, The Fight for Life. We got word up in San Jose, and John Steinbeck told us we had to get back. He was a supervisor on the picture. And so we hurried off in Woody's old Ford. We got along pretty good. We came down picking up people along the way. We came down through past Bakersfield. We got on the grapevine curve there. And I looked ahead, and there was a wheel off the car running up in front. I says, Woody, look ahead. There's a wheel. The wheel's off the car. Woody says, hell, let's catch up with it. Well, we got to the hospital all right, where Woody's wife was having her baby. The baby was named Will, after me, William. It's a funny thing, you know, how life tricks life pays you. That boy, William, when he was 21 years old, he was killed on that same highway. Worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. Now, but I won't be worried long. So long. I ride is 21 coaches long. Train I ride is 21 coaches long. The train soon be done and gone. My daughter Kate was born in that picture. Right after that, I took off, got a job in New York playing Jeter Lester in Tobacco Road. I told Woody I'd be seeing him, keep on singing songs, making up songs, and made up a new song every day. And I went back east, and about a week or two after Woody packed Kate, my wife, on the train. That's my favorite wife. She got to Kansas City, she got off to mail a letter and left her guitar and Katie on the train. The train went off to Chicago without her. Next day she caught up, was the mother that got lost, got caught up. There's such a hullabaloo about in all the newspapers, front page stories and everything. Woody heard about it even, although he didn't read the papers much. And they put the family in Who's Who in America. But don't pay any attention to publicity at all. That Who's Who in America is just a plot to get you to buy a copy. Well, Woody set off too to follow us. I told him to come back and get into the big time himself. He really hit the big time. You better come back and get some shoes on those kids. He had two or three by that time out in Oklahoma. So he set back to visit them for a while. Came right back through the Arizona and the panhandle of Texas and back through Oklahoma long enough to say hello to his wife and pick up some underwear. Sewed himself into it for the winter. Came across the country through Kansas. got there in New York in the blizzard of 1940, February. But on the way, he certainly made up some of the things in this song that's world famous today.
This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. As I went walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me that golden skyway. I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest through the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. I roamed and rambled, I followed my footsteps through the sparkling sands of dirt diamond deserts, and all around me a voice was sounding, this land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. When the sun comes shining, then I was strolling, and the wheat fields waving, and the dust clouds rolling, and a voice was chanting as I was walking, this land was made for you and me. This land is your land, this land is my land, from California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. This land is my land, from California to the New York Island.
As he came across the country, Woody Guthrie had a lot of people asking him, will you teach me how to play the guitar? That's my advice to people who go into the theater, too. But this is what Woody says. Hell yes, I'll teach you how to play the guitar. You pick up a guitar, you plank your ass against a barn or a wall, and you start fiddling with the strings of the guitar, and you get a crowd around you big enough to take up a collection, you know how to play the guitar. That was his advice to people coming across the country.
You're going to take up a collection?
No, I don't think I have a collection of that. But anyway, he used to take up collections at a lot of meetings around. When he first got into New York, he landed in the middle of the big snowstorm blizzard of 1940. New York, and he headed first out towards the Bowery, landed up in the Bowery, and he wrote a few songs about the winos and the... Well, anyway, he said, I hit New York City in the big blizzard of 1940, and I headed for the Skid Row on the Bowery. I won't go begging nobody. A feller might give me some help, and I'd be much obliged, but I'll not beg you. I'll take it easy, but I'll dang sure take it. Since I seen the difference between the rich and the poor, I don't feel at home in the Bowery no more. He said, I always called a song just a song, and I didn't even hear the word ballad or the word folk till I hit New York City in 1940. Written February 18th of 1940 in the city of New York on West 56th Street in Will Geer's house, in the charge of his wine and in the shadow of his kindness. The rent there was $150 a month, and he thought that was for the whole year. I like my good whiskey, I like my good wine, and good-looking women to have a good time, cocktail parties and a big built-in bar, but I don't feel at home in the Bowery no more. With a good thought for Herta Geer and Katie is a 7 months old red-headed husky, pretty like a picture. Herta is older than that. She's the mama and pretty like another picture. And I dedicate this song to the Geer family and the bum situation up and down the Bowery and the Skid Rows all over the country. This bum situation is a pretty big situation. Since I wrote up this song, another third Geer has been added. Her name is Ella Geer, and this song is just as much Ella's as it is any of the other Geers. And this makes a song with four Geers forward and none backward. The bum situation.
Well, I'm just a lonesome traveler, the great historical bum. Highly educated, out of history I have come. Well, I built the Rock of Ages, that was in the year of one. And that was about the biggest thing that man has ever done. I worked in the Garden of Eden, well, that was in the year of two. I joined the Apple Pickers Union, and I always paid my dues. Well, it was me who signed the contract to raise the rising sun, and now that was about the biggest thing that man has ever done. I defeated the Pharaoh's army, I defeated the mighty Turks, and I brought down Nero's army in about 10 minutes' work. Oh, I fought the greatest leaders, and I whooped them ever one. And that was about the biggest thing that man has ever done.
And I ran into the almanacs.
Was a revolution.
How about that?
Almanacs. I brought that out.
When we
basement
set
of the old
country
hotel.
Free. Oh yes, I was at Bull Run and in the Civil War, all three of them. Well, we won the Battle of Hastings. We won at Bully Run, and that was about the biggest thing that man has ever done. Now there's a feller across the ocean, I guess you knowed him well. His name was Adolf Hitler, God damned his soul to hell. Oh, we kicked him in his panzers, and we put him on the run. And now that was the biggest thing that man has ever done.